You know, I can remember as a little kid, they used to raise a lot of wheat. Of a morning, I'd be laying in my bed, then I'd hear a whistle blowing in this direction, and a whistle blowing in the other direction. They were thrashing wheat with steam engines. They'd blow their whistle to get their crew to come together. They had steam up, they were ready to thrash.
That steamer always fascinated me. It was a big hunk of iron out there. You couldn't hear a thing. It always fascinated me. It does to this day. If there's a steam engine running someplace, I'll go watch it. First job, part of harvesting I remember is cutting the grain with a binder. That binder would make bundles of grain, which had to be shocked, and then later on threshed.
Well, the binder goes down and cuts the wheat, puts it up in the elevator and runs it onto a platform, and then it has a big needle there like a baler, and that ties a string around it. And you've got this drops it off the side, and you've got a bundle carrier there, and you get about five bundles on there, and then you drop it. And then after you get that done, well, then you have to shock it. That's up to about 10 bundles in a shock.
Thrashing day would start pretty early, probably at 7 o'clock in the morning, and they would probably go to about 7 at night.
All the neighbors had a threshing crew, and I'd sit by the side of the road waiting for that huge, huge engine with the thresher to come in the yard.
The steamer would pull the threshing machine and park it, and then turn around, back up, and run it by a belt.
Hey, you gonna put a twist in it?
Huh?
You gonna put a twist in it?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
You got a twist in it so the belt doesn't flop. See, the steamer's running forward towards the thrasher, and the thrasher's running forward towards the steamer, so by putting a twist in it, it'll make it run the right direction.
There you go. Shine right in the fireball.
I remember helping pump water out of the stock tank to a wagon that would take the water out to the steam engine. And the guy that run the water wagon, he act like he had to pump it full all by himself, which made us all the more wanted to run the pump. You know, he got the boys a pump in the water, and the kids had to see to the water jugs were full.
My job then was to carry water, fill the jugs. Of course, when you got to the windmill, fill your jugs, the wind quit blowing, so you had to put the lever pump water.
And there'd be bundle haulers, there'd be grain haulers.
There would be 9 hay racks with men driving the hay racks with horses, of course.
Our kid couldn't wait till he thought he was a big man, you know, when he could run a bundle rack. The horses get used to walking where they know they're supposed to go, and you walk alongside the rack with a pitchfork and you pick up a bundle at a time and put it on a rack, you lay them flat.
You'd always have the grain part of the bundle in the center of the rack, and you'd fill up a side so far, and then you'd go on the other side of the shocks and fill the other side half, back and forth till you had a load.
So us young kids were bundle haulers. Our dad supplied us with a hay rack and a team of horses, and we go out and pick up shocks and load our wagons as high as our pitchfork could reach.
Build it up as high as you can, and then you go in and pull up alongside the thrash machine and put it into the thrash machine a bundle at a time.
The knives up there that are going up and down, that's what cuts the strings off of the bundles, and then you always put the heads in first, and that's what'll go ahead and get it to thrash right. It just thrashes it better if the heads go first.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll come a little closer. teeth down there. See, the cylinder's the same way, and that's what tears the head apart and thrashes the grain. Then it goes in there, and there's a blower and a sieve that shake. The sieve shake back and forth to shake the dust and straw and hulls out. And then the blower keeps it raised up so that it'll let the grain drop down. Grain is heavier, it'll go to the bottom. And that way the grain will come to this auger that goes in the truck, and the straw will go on the plow.
The grain went in like this, and it'd strip it off, then separate it somewhat. And then the screens back there, the seed would fall, and the light stuff would stay on top.
Separate the grain from the straw. That's what the threshing machine does.
So the seed would drop off here and go in an auger and up into a grain wagon. Your straw would keep going on to the back end, fall in this big blower and blow out to make your huge stack. Some of them got pretty huge.
Very valuable, that straw. You can use it for bedding in the barn, for horses, cattle. In fact, when I grew up, we used that bedding from that straw in our mattresses. And we changed that once or twice a year, the mattresses. That was straw in the mattresses.
It was an exciting day. They would begin working, and there'd always be one or two of the neighbors that would come to the house to help my mother prepare the meal.
Usually got fed pretty good. Then the women, it was kind of a contest from all the women putting up a big meal at noon.
Potatoes, always vegetable, all you wanted to eat. And the women worked just as hard as the men, if not harder. They had to work inside where it was hot. And you have to admire those ladies.
My job was to put a bench out in the yard and bring in pails of water, take the soap out and towels, because they always cleaned up outside, washed their faces and their hair and their arms.
And it was kind of fun. Your neighbors, you got acquainted with them, have fun, you know, pull tricks on each other. Usually somebody before the threshing season was over, it would get sold in the stock tank.
Oh, there was a lot of ornery things took place, tying bundles to the rack so they couldn't pick them off with a pitchfork. You know, they'd try it, didn't come, you'd try it again. They'd pull the pin out of the double tree, so they start the horses up while the horses left and the wagon stayed.
And the guy that run the steamer, he wanted to make sure that the people who threw the bundles into the machine wouldn't overdo it and plug it up. That'd be terrible chore to clean out. So I remember one time he dared us to plug the machine. He just wanted us to work harder. So neighbor kid and myself, we decided we was going to plug her. We weren't going to pay any attention to him. If he waved, we wouldn't do nothing. And we had that belt just flopping in the air. Could hardly pull the machine. And he got pretty close to us to let us know to slow down.
My job with some of the neighbor kids would be to haul the wheat. If we were putting it in the bin, we would haul it down to the granary and unload it with scoop shovels and take the wagon back and get another load.
Then the women, after that, after the meal, would get the dishes done and start preparing the lunch.
With us, our threshing run was, we had supper too before we left, but we got home after dark. Dad always got the thresh machine greased up, ready to go for the next morning. So it was long days. Time you got your chores done after you got home, and he'd done it before daylight in the morning, so it made it a long day.